Good evening to all. Today we are going to start that is continuation of that last class we discussed random variables, discrete random variable and continuous random variable. Based on this, the distributions are divided into two types: discrete probability distributions, continuous probability distributions. Yesterday I have given in the last some examples of discrete distributions and continuous distributions. Now we are going to start with probability mass function for a discrete random variable. For a continuous random variable, how we define the probability, that is probability density function, and then cumulative distribution function, and then the what I gave that binomial, Poisson, normal, that in the next session. Okay, definitions, DEF. First one, let X be a discrete random variable. Please, now onwards, you please understand RV. If I write RV, that full form is random variable. If I write DRV, the full form is discrete random variable. CRV, continuous random variable. Okay? Discrete random variable just takes value x1, x2, so on. Maybe finite or infinite. Countably finite or infinite. Okay. Then a function p of x are denoted by p of capital X is equal to x, which is also in some textbooks denoted by x is equal to xi. Satisfies the following conditions, comma, is called probability mass function, short form PMF, probability mass function. First condition is P of X greater than or equal to 0 for all small x. Summation over x, p of x is equal to 1, where summation runs, summation takes all values of x in the given range. Okay. Whenever a function p of x satisfying the two conditions, probability of a point x, what is that x value here, x1, x2, so on. Each x1, x2 is denoted by capital X. Sometimes this is given denoted by p of capital X equal to x, or like this, I is running from 1 to n. Okay. So each probability is greater than or equal to 0. And sum of all the properties is equal to 1, where the sum is taken over all possible values of x in the range. Range means these are x values. Because random variable is a function from codomain, sample space, and range is a part of real numbers or set of real numbers. Okay? Definition 2. Let x be a continuous RV, random variable, that is given in the form of interval or range like that. Okay. Then a function f of x satisfies the following conditions is called probability density function, short form is PDF. the two conditions are as above, f of x greater than or equal to 0 for every x, 2. For every x means in the given range, only in the given interval only, here also in the given x values only. Integration over x, f of x dx, that is for the given interval each is denoted by small x. So in the integration over the given x values of f of x dx is equal to 1, that is integration f of x dx, what are these x values, that are the given range, that is the x continuous random variable values, here to consider lower limit and left upper limit, then integrate this fx, the value should be 1. In the discrete case, in the discrete random variable, we are denoting the probabilities p of x. That means to avoid the confusion between the notation probability in discrete and continuous. In a discrete case, the probability denoted by p of x. But in some textbooks, it is given by f of x also, both same notation. In a continuous random variable, the probability denoted by f of x. So p of x is also called probability mass function, provided two conditions are satisfied. Each probability greater than, probability of every point greater than or equal to 0, summation over x, p of x is equal to 1, that is sum of all the probabilities is equal to 1. Now in the case of continuous, the probability function denoted by f of x, which is called probability density function, if the two conditions satisfied, f of x greater than or equal to 0 as above, and integration fx over the given x values, that is least value of x is lower limit, highest value of x is upper limit, that integration value is 1. Okay. And here I am writing third point. The cumulative distribution function of a random variable capital X, in bracket short form is CDF, is denoted by capital F of x and is given by capital F of x is equal to probability of x less than or equal to small x, and this is equal to two cases, summation xi less than or equal to x p of xi if x is DRV, discrete random variable. In the second case, integration minus infinity to x f of x dx if x is continuous random variable. Now, cumulative, you know the meaning of cumulative. Suppose at this point we are finding the probability in the cumulative case. That means it tells that the probability of a value not only at that point but also its preceding values, and then adding all these probabilities. Okay, suppose x is equal to 2. Capital F of 2 means you add the probabilities of 2 and less than or equal to 2. Okay, so that means probability at x and below it, before its value, below its values also you consider into this case. In the case of discrete you add, in the case of integration, that is you have, in the case of continuous you should apply integration. So cumulative means not only at that point probability but also its previous values. In the case of discrete you add all these things, in the case of integration, in the case of continuous you should integrate. Okay, so for example, see x values 0, 1, 2, so on, 10 consecutive integers. If I asked f of 2, that means I have taken x, this is small x, one of the small x values. Now what is the notation in the case of discrete? P of x less than or equal to 2. What is the meaning of this one? Probability of the values at 2 and less than or equal to 2, adding all these. So this comes 0 plus 1 plus 2, that means right from the beginning you consider all these, right from the beginning you consider and then again add, right from the beginning you consider to reach the required x value and then adding. Suppose your x values, just see, minus infinity to less than x less than infinity. So if I ask the same capital F of 2 in the discontinuous case, what I give? Minus infinity to x. This is minus infinity. What is x? I have taken example 2 into f of x dx. So in the case of continuous, we don't know that x value. That's why the last value of x, if we do not know, in the case of continuous, minus infinity. The least value of x in the case of continuous, if it is not mentioned, minus infinity. Similarly, in the case of discrete, if it is not mentioned, okay, this is the notation adopted. That is, what is xi less than or equal to x? Here, at which value, at which point we are finding capital F, that is cumulative distribution, at a small x. Small x is one of the values of the given random variable. At that point, we are finding cumulative. So, what is the meaning? Summation of all the probabilities at that point x and its preceding x values also. That is, preceding means less than or equal to xi less than or equal to x, p of xi. In the case of continuous, so collect all the values less than that number x. If it is not mentioned, in the case of continuity, in the case of continuity, what is the last value? Minus infinity. Minus infinity to x. Okay. Now, after this, I am giving properties and examples. So, capital Fx in the case of continuous, I have given through integration. So, whenever we know capital Fx, if we find small fx, this is the relation. D by dx of cumulative distribution function gives that probability density function, that is PDF. Okay. 2. Capital F of minus infinity, 0. Capital F of infinity, 1. Because what I gave that PDF, a random variable continuous x, x be a continuous random variable, f of x, small f of x is called a property density function if two conditions I have given. What is second condition? Integration over given x values, fx dx equal to 1. What are that given x values? According to this, if you put infinity, minus infinity, infinity, that means covering all points in the continuous space, automatically it is value 1 only. Okay. 3. P of A less than X less than B is equal to P of A less than or equal to X less than B is equal to P of A less than X less than or equal to B is equal to P of A less than or equal to X less than or equal to B. This is happened in the case of integral A to B F of X dx if X is CRV, continuous random variable. In the continuous random variable, no change. That means all are having same answer. Whether it is less than or equal to, greater than or equal to. Comparing with your x value. Okay, A, B are the given values. Next, 4. P of x less than A plus P of x greater than or equal to A. That means it covers all numbers of the random variable. Always sum of the properties is always 1. So, which implies what we conclude here, whenever we want P of x less than A, so, P of subtract the quantity from 1, P of x greater than or equal to A. And whenever we want P of x greater than A, subtract the probability less than or equal to A from 1. So, this fourth point I will tell you where it is useful. For example, your x values 0, 1, 2, so on 10. The question asks P of x greater than 1. So, x greater than 1, what are the x values comparing this x greater than 1, what we got this, what we will get with this consideration 2, 3, 4, 5, so on. So, each point you have to find probability and then adding, okay. But, here 1 is near to 0, but far away from 10. So in that case, 1 minus, that is sum of all the points, probability is always 1. 1 minus, here greater than 1 means 2 to 10 coming. So which are not coming here, 0 and 1. That is P of x less than or equal to 1. What is less than or equal to 1? According to my consideration, probability of 1 plus probability of 0. Subtract these two probabilities from 1. Okay. Suppose if I ask probability of x less than 8. X less than 8, according to this consideration, how many points? 0, 1, 2, 3, so on, 7. So it is more, calculating each point and then adding. But 8 is near to 10 and far away from 0. So subtract the probabilities from 1 where the values not coming here. What is coming here? Less than 8 means 0 to 7. Not coming x values using this condition is 8, 9, 10. 8, 9, 10 can be written as P of x greater than or equal to 8. That is the meaning. In such cases, this point is useful. Okay. For example, if I ask 1 less than x less than 5, that is in the case of discrete, P of A less than x less than B. Now, according to my consideration 0 to 10, what are the values lying between 1 to 5? P of 2 plus P of 3 plus P of 5. In discrete case, you should add. In the continuous case, you should integrate. In the continuous case, I have given like that. Okay. In the case of continuous and cumulative distribution function, whenever it is available, this is given by capital F of B minus capital F of A. Okay. Next, capital F of X is non-decreasing function. Non-decreasing function. That is, it is always increasing function. Why? Suppose X value is 1, 2, 3, 3 only. Find capital F cumulative distribution function at 1, at 2, at 3. Where you will get maximum? That is at 3 only. That means capital F value is always, cumulative distribution function is always greater than or equal to 0 and it is non-decreasing. That means it is always increasing graph. Suppose X value is 1, 2, 3. Find capital F at 1 and find capital F at 2, which is greater than the previous value. Next, find capital F at 3, which is greater than the previous two values, which is always increasing. It is non-decreasing. Okay. And you can write here also 0 less than or equal to capital F x, because probability is always lying between 0 to 1. Capital F is also nothing but probability, but not only at x point but also its previous values, whatever it may be, adding any number of probability values in the same game, which is maximum value 1 and minimum value 0 only. That is, please by heart these points. Expectation, comma, variance, comma, standard deviation of a random variable capital X. First point. E of x is the expected value of x or mean, similarly, average of random variable capital X. Or you can write here capital X. And is given by E of X. Another notation, mu capital X or X bar is equal to two cases, summation over X, X into P of X, if X is discrete random variable, integration over X, X into F of X dx, if X is continuous random variable. So, X is a random variable, may be continuous or discrete, then this is called average or mean or expected value of the given random variable denoted by any of these notations or small x bar also. And in the case of discrete, summation over the given x values, x times of its probability. That is adding all the quantities given x and x times of its probability. That is given x multiplied by its probability, correct all these things. Okay, and then adding, which gives mean of the random variable. In the case of continuous, integration over all given x values, x times of its probability density function. Because I told you, in the case of discrete, probability denoted by P of X. In the case of continuous, your probability denoted by F of X. Okay. Similarly, expectation of any function, that is say G of X, is equal to summation over X, G of X into P of X. That means G of X means, suppose X plus 1, X square, X plus 1 whole cube, like that. Okay. If X is discrete random variable, integration over X, G of X into F of X dx, if X is continuous random variable. Just I am giving an indication here, G of X is, don't worry, any capital X function, capital X square or capital X cube, like that. V of X is the variance of a random variable capital X, comma, defined as V of X, sometimes this is sigma square. The suffix indicates it is not partial derivative. It is the meaning of that random variable, that variable we are finding variance. Okay, is equal to expectation of X minus X bar whole square. X bar is the mean of the random variable X. Expectation of deviations from the mean. Square of the deviations of the mean. X minus X bar whole square. Okay. And this is simplified to expectation of X square minus expectation of whole square. Okay. So, this is nothing but X bar. Okay. So, what I am, where I put, see, where I put the tick, that means that is useful for problems purpose. This is for results or sub-results or lemma. When we know a main theorem, then from that theorem, if we want sub-results or directions, lemma, all these things, then, okay, use these type of results. Whenever in the problem, we require variance of X, then these results will help, okay? Wherever I put the tick, that is useful for problems purpose, okay? Next, 3. SD, standard deviation, short form, okay, of a random variable X is given by sigma X. But in some test it is given by sigma only. The suffix indicates the respective variable only. Is equal to positive square root of variance of X. So, after finding square root for the given variance, which gives standard deviation, okay, plus, or better to put, plus, so this is the procedure, the tick part. path is very important for problems purpose. See, whenever in the case of discrete, a function is called probability function, sum of all the probabilities is equal to 1. In the case of continuous random variable, a function probability is given, then integration that f of x dx is always 1. Very, very important this point. Problems. So this is given 2007, 2 marks. The random variable RV, capital X, takes on the values 1, 2, 3 with probabilities 2 plus 5p by 5, comma 1 plus 3p by 5, comma 1.5 plus 2p by 5 respectively. The value of P and expectation of X are respectively dash. Now, see, here x values 1, 2, 3 with probabilities P of 1 is equal to 2 plus 5p by 3, P of 2 is equal to 1 plus 3p by 5, and P of 3 is equal to, probability of 3 is equal to 1.5 plus 2p by 5. Sorry, this is 5. We know that KT, that's capital P, that is probability function, summation x is equal to 1, 2, 3, P of x is equal to 1. What is 1, 2, 3? X values are given 1, 2, 3. What is P of x? Its probabilities. Okay. Which implies P of 1 plus P of 2 plus P of 3 is equal to 1. Which implies adding the numerators 2 plus 1, 3 plus 1.5, 4.5, 5 plus 3, 8 plus 2, 10p. Divide by 5 is equal to 1. So, p is equal to 5 minus 4.5, 0.5, 0.5 by 10, 0.05. Okay. And expectation of x, what I gave the definition, summation over x, x values 1, 2, 3. X times its probability. Okay, that means 1 into P of 1 plus 2 into P of 2, run 1 by 1 x, 3 into P of 3, give 1 by 1 value to x, and summation means adding all these things. So what is P of 1? It is given 2 plus 5p by 5 plus 2 times of P of 2, that is 2 plus 6p by 5, 3 times 3 into 1.5, that is 4.5 plus 6p divided by 5. So this simplifies to 2 plus 2, 4 plus 4.5, 8.5, 5, 6, 11, 6, 17p. P stands for 0.05 and then divide by 5. 17, 5 is 85. So this is 8.5 plus 0.85 divided by 5. Later you simplify. So this tells that 5, 8, 5, 13, 1 means 9 divided by 5. 5 ones, 43, 5 eights, 1.87. Another example. Given a PDF probability density function is of the form P of x is equal to k times minus alpha mod x, x belongs to minus infinity comma infinity, full stop. The value of k comma is, solution. So here PDF denoted by P of x, but in many textbooks it is given as same notation. Sometimes to avoid the confusion, P of x is probability mass function, small f of x is probability density function. Okay, but in some textbooks both are denoted by P of x or both are denoted by f of x, small f of x. Since P of x is probability density functions, so one of the condition is integration P of x dx is equal to 1. What are x values? Minus infinity to infinity. So here k is constant, which is multiplicative constant, keep outside. And this is given as twice 0 to infinity. This becomes, because exponential minus alpha mod x is positive quantity, because mod x is positive. Even function, okay, is equal to 1. Since exponential minus mod alpha x is even function, in calculus I have given that even function, odd function, minus a to a f of x dx equal to twice into 0 to f of a, 0 to a f of x dx. In the case of f of x is even, here f of x is constant into e power minus alpha mod x, that is going to even function, because mod x is even function, mod x is equal to plus or minus x, okay. Or what is the procedure of even function? Put x is equal to minus x, simplify. If you get the given function, that is even function. Or otherwise, if you get minus into given function, then it is odd function. Otherwise, it is neither even nor odd function. Please refer that calculus, some definitions I have given. Okay, now, so 0 to infinity means positive values. So that is x is taken to be positive. So I have given mod x definition. Mod x is equal to x if x greater than 0. And mod x is equal to x if x greater than 0. Greater than 0 means, if it is not mentioned, then you take up to that last value of last value in the case of continuous, that is last value is here infinity. So that's why it is 0 to infinity. 2k times 0 to infinity e power minus alpha mod x dx is equal to 1. That means I can remove here mod. Okay, why? This is the reason. X greater than 0 means 0 to infinity numbers are all denoted by x greater than 0. Okay. Now, e power ax integration, e power ax divided by a, limits 0 to infinity. Basic calculus integration formulas. Okay. So, this simplifies to 2k with minus alpha, exponential minus infinity, exponential 0 is equal to 1. So, this simplifies to k is equal to alpha by 2. Copy down. Oh. 2006, 2 marks. Consider the continuous random variable CRV with PDF f of t is equal to two cases, two subintervals given, 1 plus t, 1 minus t. In this case, t values minus 1 less than or equal to t less than or equal to 0. In this case, t value is 0 less than or equal to t less than or equal to 1. Full stop. The SD, that is standard deviation of the random variable is dash. Just using normal integrations only, analytical methods, what we have discussed. Basic definition sometimes. Otherwise, integration by parts also you will get while evaluating these problems in the case of continuous. So, little bit integration you should remember in all the procedures. I mean, definite integral properties also you have to remember. Some problems you may get that results. So what is given? So standard deviation means, first of all, we have to find expectation of x mean, and then expectation of x square, and then find variance of x. After that, standard deviation is equal to square root of variance. Okay, so expectation of random variable t. What is t here? Random variable. Small t is the values of capital T. So what is the definition? Summation t into f of t, because it is given continuous. So integration t times f of t dt. What are t values? Minimum minus 1, maximum 1. But this is not given directly f of, that means f of t is not given directly minus 1 to 1, which is given in different subintervals, that is minus 1 to 0 and 0 to 1. So according to definite integral properties, this split into according to the these t values. This integration splitting into according to these t values, minus 1 to 0, your f of t value 1 plus t plus 0 to 1 t times your f of t value in the second case, minus 1 minus t dt. So t into 1, t integration t square by 2 plus t into 2, t square integration t cube by 3, limits minus 1 to 0 plus here also t square by 2 minus t cube by 3, limits 0 to 1. This simplifies to 0. You check it. Substitute the upper limit and lower limit, both expressions in total simplifies to 0. Next, we have to find E of t square. Just replace t by t square in the above. Minus 1 to 1 t square into f of t dt. So, first notation starts with capital variables. And while evaluating, either by discrete or continuous, summation and integration contains small variable only. So this is again, according to the given function value, two different subintervals, you split into accordingly. Okay. So minus 1 to 0, t square into 1 minus 1 plus t dt, plus 0 to 1, the second value is given, t square times 1 minus t dt. So t square into 1, t square into 2, t cube. So t square integration t cube by 3, t cube integration t power 4 divided by 4, limits minus 1 to 0. Just you remember, you need here in these problems, we are getting only basic integration standard results. Sometimes you may get integration by parts or definite integral properties, what we have discussed in previously. Okay, t square integration t cube by 3 and t power 4 integration, that means t cube integration t power 4 by 4, limits 0 to 1. This simplifies to 1 by 6. Please check it. So therefore, V of x, variance, what I gave, that means in one step I put the tick, use that step. Expectation of, I mean not x here, t, random variable is given t. Expectation of t square minus expectation of t whole square, that is square of the mean. Expectation of t square we got 1 by 6, expectation of t, that is mean of the random variable t, we got 0. So, which implies standard deviation of the random variable capital T is sigma is equal to square root of variance of t. That that is 1 by root over 6. So one more question. 2012, 2 marks given. Consider a random variable capital X that takes values plus 1 and minus 1 with probability 0.5 each. Full stop. The values of the cumulative distribution function capital F of X at x is equal to minus 1 and plus 1 r. So what is capital F X cumulative distribution function? This is CDF of a random variable capital X, which is defined as probability of X less than or equal to X. So therefore capital F of minus 1, put small x is equal to minus 1. And what are capital X values? Minus 1 comma 1 with P of minus 1 0.5, similarly P of 1 0.5. So less than or equal to minus 1 means from the given x values only two values minus 1 to 1. So this condition satisfying with these values only minus 1. So this is nothing but P of minus 1. Less than or equal to minus 1 means x value is minus 1 and less than minus 1. But here starting value of x is given minus 1. No more value, no preceding values. So what is P of minus 1? 0.5. And capital F of plus 1, that is P of x less than or equal to 1. What is the meaning of less than or equal to 1? At x is equal to 1 and then less than 1. So according to the given values, both are comes here. Adding all these, P of minus 1 plus P of 1. That means 0.5 plus 0.5 is equal to 1. That means every problem at the last value of x, whether it is discrete or continuous, your capital F function value, CDF, cumulative distribution function, at the last value of the given random variable is always 1, that is 100%. One more example, 2 marks, 2004. 5 minutes. Five minutes. an examination paper has 150 multiple choice questions of 1 mark each, comma, with each question having 4 choices, full stop. Each incorrect answer fetches 0.25 mark, full stop. Suppose 1,000 students choose all their answers randomly with uniform probability stop. The sum total of the expected marks obtained by all these students, comma, is dash. So here it is, how many questions? 150 questions. Each question having 4 choices. One incorrect, that means one is wrong, all other 3 are true. So each incorrect answer fetches how many marks? -0.25. So what is the correct answer? The choice is 3/4 probability. What is the incorrect answer? 1/4 probability. What is the marks per each question when it is wrong? -0.25. So automatically when it is correct, okay. If the answer is correct, then marks per each question is 1 mark. If the answer is incorrect answer fetches for a wrong answer, your marks is negative marks, that is -0.25. So probability of getting a correct the question is correct, that is the answer is correct, is 3/4, because 3 choices are correct. Okay, I mean out of 4 choices, 1 is correct, all the other 3 are false. So probability of correct answer is 1/4. And the incorrect answer is 3/4, like that. So I am giving the hint, after defining the sentence by a random variable x, one of the sentences available in here, marks per question. Let random variable x is equal to marks obtained per question.